Silent Hill 3, one of the classic psychological horror games made by Team Silent from Konami, was released in 2003 for PS2 and PC. It was also released for PS3 and Xbox 360 in 2012 as part of the Silent Hill HD collection. So, considering emulation, there are many ways to play this game on PC today. And in this video, we're going to take a look at all of them and find out which option is the best way to play this classic on PC. Let's start by trying out the original PS2 version running on the PCSX2 emulator. This game was originally developed for the PlayStation 2 and then ported to other platforms, so this should be the most authentic way to experience this game. And yes, on PCSX2 with the correct settings, which I'll talk more about later, every graphical effect is reproduced correctly, and the game looks great. There are a few things to note though. On PS2, Silent Hill 3 was limited to 30fps in a 4:3 aspect ratio, so normally that would also be the case on PCSX2. There are, however, two patches available to work around these limitations. Unfortunately, both of these patches introduce some issues. The widescreen patch extends the view, but in doing so, it shows parts of the screen that are not rendered properly. And the 60fps patch works great for the most part, but I've ran into an issue where these bugs in this room are invisible with the patch on, which means there might be other areas with similar glitches. So if you're using PCSX2, I'd recommend playing without these patches. Another thing to note is that on the PS2 version of Silent Hill 3, the game uses per-vertex lighting on the flashlight, much like Silent Hill 2 did, and as we'll see later, the other versions use the superior per-pixel lighting. By the way, I've made a video like this for Silent Hill 2 as well, if you're interested, the link is in the description. Aside from that, all of the PCSX2 footage shown so far has been using the HD texture pack made by Ice Bullet, which is a nice improvement over the original textures. You can find a link to the texture pack in the description. And although I've been showing the game running in 4K so far, obviously you can also play the game at native resolution for that nostalgic look. Now here are the settings I've used for this video. The most important one is the blend accuracy setting, which needs to be set to full for all of the effects to work correctly. Now let's move on to the next option, which is the PC version of Silent Hill 3. Despite being a PC port developed internally by Konami in 2003, I was surprised when I tried it out without any patches or fixes. The game ran fine, with most visual effects working correctly, supporting 60fps, and it even worked with my DualSense controller out of the box. Also, like I mentioned before, the flashlight uses per-pixel lighting, which looks better than per-vertex lighting in the PS2 version. There were a few issues with this version, though. The game is limited to 4:3 display resolutions, and the highest one it supports is 2048x1536. I also couldn't open the in-game options menu as the game would freeze if I tried, and the frame rate would fluctuate a lot for seemingly no reason. The audio quality is also lower than the PS2 version, with music and sound effects playing at the wrong pitch and speed. Fortunately, there are mods available to fix most of these issues. The first one is the Silent Hill 3 PC fix by Steam 006. It fixes all of the issues related to resolution and graphics, and adds a bunch of extra options on its config file. With this mod, the game supports widescreen properly, with the correct field of view during cutscenes, and runs at high resolutions like 4K. The other mod I'd recommend using is the Audio Enhancement Pack by Mario Tainaka. This mod uses the sound files from the PS2 version to recreate the sound effects properly at full quality. You can find links to both mods in the description. With these mods, the PC version of Silent Hill 3 becomes almost equal to the PS2 version. I did notice some small differences though. The depth of field effect, even with the mod, looks diminished compared to the PS2 version on PCSX2, and the shadows also look slightly sharper on the PC version. There are resolution settings for both of these effects on the configuration file for the PC fix mod, but I tried changing these values and couldn't match the PS2 version still. Aside from that, this boss has a shiny shader on the PC version that looks different from PCSX2. And finally, as far as I know, there are no texture mods for the PC version, unlike PCSX2.
Yeah, I guess it was. Anyway, I'm coming home now.
Now there are two more versions to look at, but they are from the Silent Hill HD collection. If you're not familiar with it, the HD Collection was a very controversial release from Konami for many reasons. It was outsourced to a studio named Hijinx that only had experience with mobile games, and they were given an outdated and incomplete version of the game's source code, because apparently Konami had lost the complete code. In addition to that, Konami re-recorded all of the voice acting due to negotiation problems with one of the voice actors. The result was a complete mess, full of bugs and glitches, missing visual and sound effects, and with new voiceovers that are considered to be inferior to the original. So, we know more or less what to expect from these versions, but since they are playable on RPCS3 and Xenia, just out of curiosity, let's check them out. Starting with the PS3 version of Silent Hill 3 from the HD Collection running on the RPCS3 emulator.
Where am I?
This option supports 16:9, and the emulator allows you to increase the resolution and the frame rate up to 60 FPS, so the emulation itself is solid, but as I mentioned before, the actual game has many issues compared to the previous options. Here are some of them. The iconic fog is missing during gameplay and looks broken during cutscenes. Bloom is missing, which makes the visuals look washed out in comparison. Self-shadowing on character models is missing. Sound effects are usually weird or broken. The transition to the save screen fades to white instead of red. Anyway, you get the point. Not a great way to play this game. In case you're interested, here are the settings I've used for this video. Finally, let's take a quick look at the Xbox 360 version of Silent Hill 3 from the HD Collection running on the Xenia emulator. It's the same game as the PS3 version, so all of the issues mentioned before are still present here. But in addition to that, the emulation is not great either. Even on the Canary version of Xenia, the game runs poorly, even at native resolution, and with constant glitching on models, as you can see in the footage. The lens flare is also not working, and on some cutscenes, the audio breaks and goes completely silent. But anyway, obviously this version is not recommended. So, with all things considered, which version is the best one? Well, obviously it's between the PC version and the PS2 version running on PCSX2. I'd say there's no clear winner between these two options. They are both great ways to play the game. The PS2 version is the original one, so the visual effects are displayed in the most accurate way, and it has a nice HD texture pack available. But, to avoid any issues, you need to play it at 30 FPS and with 4:3 aspect ratio. The PC version, on the other hand, fully supports widescreen and 60 FPS, and it has per-pixel lighting, but some visual effects are not as accurate, and it requires downloading and installing mods. In the end, the choice is up to you. Just make sure to never touch the HD Collection and you'll be fine. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, leave a like and subscribe for more. If you want to get in touch with me, follow me on X. If you have any suggestions for games you want to see compared like this, leave it in the comments below or send me on X. I'd appreciate that. Anyway, thanks for watching and I'll see you next time.